After being closed since 2008, the Richard Henry Dana Branch Library in Cypress Park has been reopened. Councilmember Gil Cedillo partnered with the city's Department of Recreation and Parks and Bureau of Engineering to reopen the branch. The 2,800-square-foot building, built in 1926, has been renovated but still maintains its historical significance. In 1987, the Dana Branch was added to the National Register of Historic Places, citing the building's charming one-story New England colonial revival-style architecture. In 2011, the City of LA named the building a historic and cultural monument. Improvements include new recreation space, new lighting, new roof, and other upgrades. Each year, the City of LA hosts an award show for Oscar-nominated movies shot in California. Anita Bennett takes us to the 2016 Made in Hollywood Awards.
The paparazzi are in place and the red carpet is out for the fifth annual Made in Hollywood Awards.
This year, we're celebrating two animated feature films and one live-action feature film produced in California, right here in L.A.
Each year, the L.A. City Council recognizes Oscar-nominated films in the Best Picture and Best Animated Feature categories that were produced here in California. Paramount's stop-motion drama, Animalisa, and Disney's Inside Out made the cut.
This is disgust, and that's fear. We're Riley's Emotions.
This year, Made in Hollywood introduced two new categories, including one honoring the season's most diverse Oscar contender. The biopic about gangster rap group N.W.A. was mostly overlooked by the Oscars, igniting a firestorm of controversy. But Councilman Mitch O'Farrell's office decided to honor Straight Outta Compton with a Diversity in Hollywood Leadership Award.
We need more diversity in the industry itself, across the board. When we have that, I think that then we'll see that reflected in all the award nominations.
Meanwhile, Star Wars The Force Awakens composer John Williams received the inaugural Lifetime Contribution to Hollywood Award.
Nothing will stand in our way.
I wanted to do the music here with our orchestra here. But the people who really should be thanked for having this happen are... starting off with J.J. Abrams, who was the director of the film, and Kathy Kennedy as producer.
Williams has previously taken home five Academy Awards. In Hollywood, I'm Anita Bennett for LA This Week.
The producer of Straight Outta Compton said they were able to shoot locally after qualifying for California's film tax credits. Well, LAX's International Terminal 2 now joins the Tom Bradley International Terminal as a world-class hub for global travelers. After months of renovation, it's finally open with new and exciting dining and retail options for passengers.
These are some glimpses of the latest upgrades at the new Terminal 2 at LAX. Los Angeles World Airports and Westfield recently unveiled the new terminal featuring 16 new dining and retail brands.
And this terminal alone, the second busiest international terminal at LAX, serves more than 1 million U.S. travelers and about 4 million travelers from abroad each year. To create a better travel experience for them, we're upgrading the ticket lobby, as well as the baggage screening and the baggage claim areas, and we improved all of the terminal's electrical, mechanical, and telecom systems.
The redevelopment project took 20 months to complete.
There's also a tremendous amount of work going on behind the scenes. And that work is critically important because that enables the technology, the cooling, the environment of this building to be sustainable and to serve the passengers.
This is the terminal's first renovation in nearly 30 years. And officials say they want passengers to experience the true taste of Los Angeles.
We at Westfield wanted to showcase the soul of Los Angeles. Our goal is to understand the needs of the passenger and to deliver a Southern California experience.
Ciabatta Bar, an Italian food destination with a focus on simple organic Italian food, is among the new eateries at the terminal.
And we are very proud of our product, of making everything from scratch. So we wanted to give the same experience to the customer that come to Hollywood as well to the travelers here at the Los Angeles Airport.
It's so fitting as we have reached a record-breaking number of passengers. We expect more growth in the near term. For LAX to have another terminal besides Tom Bradley International Terminal that really reflects the uniqueness, the culture, the vibrancy of the great city of Los Angeles.
A holistic customer journey that Los Angeles World Airports hopes to create for its passengers. In Los Angeles, I'm Rasha Goel for LA This Week.
Terminal 2 serves more than 5 million passengers annually. While bicycle infrastructure, safe streets, and family fun all came into play as Reseda got rolling on its annual West Valley Community Bike Ride. Anna Marcos brings us more.
The LAPD's black and whites flashed red and blue as the West Valley Community Ride kicked off, headed by Councilmember Bob Blumenfield. This is his third year taking in some fresh air with resident bicyclists of Reseda.
That's the goal here, is we're really trying to transform this area in a positive way.
I think this is fun. This is a good ride. It's a good way to bring out the community. It's a good way to promote cycling here in the valley.
The 10-mile route meandered through streets, the Orange Line Bikeway and the L.A. River Bikeway, and LAPD cops came along for the ride.
If you see some of our officers that are bike uniform, get used to them. We're going to introduce the bike detail out here to Reseda, so it'll be great.
But Councilmember Blumenfield isn't just concerned with transforming Reseda residents and cops into bike riders. He wants to transform the area itself. After the bike ride, he held a workshop to talk about the Reseda corridor's future. Among the plans, building an ice rink for residents with Prop K money.
I love going on the bike rides, especially on weekends, since it's not having to be somewhere at a certain time. It's not commuting. And also, I want to hear what changes that they're going to do.
After the bike ride, we're going to have vision boards. We're going to have discussion. We're going to basically be getting a lot of community input on what people want to see in this area.
In honor of the occasion, the Los Angeles Kings set up a hockey rink and puck shoot. Family fun, safe streets, and healthy ways to ride and play. It looks like this bike ride was a resounding success. I'm Anna Marcos for LA This Week.
The bike ride is part of the Reseda Rising Initiative and LA's Great Streets Initiative. Well, a new group of LAPD recruits joins the force to protect and serve. Rasha Goel has more.
25 graduates recently celebrated their success in becoming the LAPD's newest officers. The graduation ceremony was held at the Los Angeles Police Academy.
You have to remember what it was inside of you that made you want to be a Los Angeles police officer. And then always be true to that. Always.
LAPD Chief Charlie Beck also reminded the recruits of their collective goals.
I want you to make this city safer, and I want you to build public trust.
Graduates were also honored for excellence in several categories, including most inspirational, weapon proficiency, and human relations.
The number one officer and recipient of the William H. Parker Award for Class 815 is Officer Daniel Battles.
We cannot wait to get out there and start doing the job that we've pursued for so long. I know it won't be easy, but with the determination that I've seen demonstrated in the academy, I know we can achieve it.
The recruits completed 920 hours of training over 24 weeks.
You are now members of a very big and very special family. You will be the people keeping a watchful eye on our communities and keeping our families and neighborhoods safe from harm. You will be the people that our city turns to in the face of a natural disaster.
They are faces of new hopes and dreams that will now spread their wings in the City of Angels. I'm Rasha Goel for LA This Week.
Of the 25 graduates, 21 were males and 4 were females. An annual event is bringing kids from all over LA together to compete in a friendly game of ball while honoring a civil rights leader.
He steals, he dribbles, he shoots, and he scores. As these kids take part in the 7th annual Dream Games, named in honor of Martin Luther King Jr.
Dr. Martin Luther King, his famous speech, "I Have a Dream."
Wearing Dr. King t-shirts, kids between the ages of 7 and 12 tipped off the games at the Westwood Recreational Center with some high-energy action on the court.
I'm just here to represent Pan Pacific in the Dream Games. Pretty excited.
The Dream Games were created to recognize Dr. King and to bring folks together for one common goal, to give kids in L.A. the chance to play sports.
Seeing kids from different parks that seem to be isolated and segregated from one another, we thought it would be a good idea to bring those kids together and make sure that they had a clear understanding of what the ethnicities were and had respect for one another.
The Dream Games are made possible through a partnership between the Department of Rec and Parks and Friends of West L.A. The games provide children from 11 different Los Angeles City recreation centers the opportunity to participate in a basketball exhibition.
This is a great example of an opportunity to recognize Martin Luther King's legacy and bring together the diversity that is Los Angeles.
Some of the 11 participating recreation centers include Chevy Chase, Costello, Cypress, Echo, Expo, Highland, and Westwood. To get the game schedule or to learn how to participate, call the Westwood Recreation Center at 310-473-3610. Well, here's your chance to see the Harlem Globetrotters in action, celebrate the Year of the Monkey with a fireworks display, and shop for some unique merchandise in downtown L.A. That's all in this week's Things to Do. They're making their way to Los Angeles during their 90th anniversary world tour. The world-famous Harlem Globetrotters will be playing two games at the Los Angeles Staples Center on February 21st. Don't miss your chance in seeing the iconic team in action. For 90 years, the Harlem Globetrotters have provided smiles, encouraged sportsmanship, and service to millions of people worldwide. A mix of athleticism, entertainment, trick shots, and ball handling will keep the family smiling and entertained. The star-studded roster features Big Easy Lofton, plus female star TNT Maddox, and more. For more information, visit HarlemGlobetrotters.com.
Under a pale blue sky.
It's the Year of the Monkey. The L.A. Chinatown Firecracker Run annual event brings family and friends to participate in the festivities. The run includes a bike ride on February 20th, a 5K run, a 10K run, and a kiddie run on February 21st. The event will also include a lighting of the fireworks ceremony and admission to the Firecracker Festival, carnival games, and petting zoo for kiddie run participants. The event will also include a lighting of the fireworks ceremony, a firecracker festival, carnival games, and petting zoo for kiddie run participants. All proceeds and donations go to local elementary schools and nonprofit community organizations providing service and programs to benefit the community. The LA Chinatown Firecracker Run Committee has contributed more than $500,000 so far. For more information, visit firecracker10k.org. Do some shopping at the Artists and Fleas during the weekend of February 20th and 21st. Located nearby downtown Los Angeles Art District, this flea market is a community event that showcases art, design, and fashion, alongside a selection of vintage and upcycled merchandise. This market also presents LA's notable food trucks, makers workshops, and special events for the entire family. From New York, Artists and Fleas branched out to LA in 2014. The market is open every third weekend from 11 to 5 p.m. For more, visit artistsandfleas.com. And that's a look at some things to do. Well, that's going to do it for this edition. I'm Yana Kane from all of us here at LA This Week. Thanks for joining us. A reminder, you can catch us online at lacityview.org. You can also follow and like us on Facebook. We'll see you back here next week for more of LA This Week.
is my daughter Miranda, and we live in Silver Lake. We love the cultural diversity of Los Angeles. You're watching LA City View, Channel 35. Our city, our channel.
Good morning. Good morning, everyone. Good morning. It is Friday the 19th. Would like to welcome each and every one of you to your Los Angeles City Hall. This council meets every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Friday at 10 a.m. The public is welcome. Madam Clerk, we do have a quorum. Would you please call the roll?
Blumenfield, Bonin, Buscaino, Cedillo, Englander, Fuentes, Herstassen, Weezer, Koretz, Krikorian, Martinez, O'Farrell, Price, Rue, Wesson. 11 members present and a quorum, Mr. President.
Thank you. First order of business.
Approval of the minutes.
Bonin moves and Rue seconds. Next.
Commendatory resolutions for approval.
Harris Dawson moves and Martinez seconds. Next.
Mr. President, there are requests to continue 1U for 30 days to March 18th.
Okay, so without objection, that'll be the order. Continue.
And the Department of Building and Safety recommends that the following items be received and filed. Items 1A, G, L, N, P, Q, R, and T, as the liens have been paid in full.
Okay, then so ordered. Let's continue.
Items 1 through 3 are items noticed for public hearing.
Do you have cards?
Yes, there are cards on all three items, 1, 2, and 3.
Okay, then let's move forward. What do we have next?
Item 4 is an item for which public hearing has been held.
Okay, members, item 4, specials. I don't see any. Why don't we prepare to vote on item 4? Let's open the roll. Close the roll. Tabulate the vote.
11 ayes.
Okay, that's approved. Let's move forward.
Items 5 through 14 are items for which public hearings have not been held. 10 votes are required for consideration.
Okay, so without objection, those items are now before this body. Do we have cards?
Yes, there are cards on all items 5 through 14.
Okay, so then that will bring us where? We'll hold those items.
Mr. President, that takes council back to presentations or items called special.
Okay, I'm going to ask Ms. Martinez if you could just sit in for a minute. Let me see if I can find a home for Sugar here, okay? Today is Pet Adoption Friday. And Mr. Harris Dawson, just let me know when you're ready and we'll get started with an unbelievably special presentation.
Mr. Harris Dawson, are you ready for your presentation? Oh, we're going to go to Mr. Wesson.
All right. Mr. Wesson, since he is trying to find a home for a dog, he's going to wait for us to get on this television screen. Let me get a close-up of Sugar here. Right, Arlene? This is Sugar. What we have is a four-month-old mixed terrier female who has all of her shots and everything, and she's ready to be taken home today. We at the City of Los Angeles have been having a pet adoption program for, I want to say 10 years. We have a 100% adoption rate. And so I'm asking for anyone that can hear my voice, anyone that can see us on television, anyone in the council chambers today, I present to you Sugar, again, a four-month-old terrier mix who's very nervous because she wants to make a good impression as she's looking for a home. I'd say about 70-80% of the dogs that we find homes for, they're individuals that are here in the audience, adopt them. So I have with me today one of our number one animal experts and just good loving people with Arlene. We've been doing this for about 10 years. So I'm going to ask Arlene to take, I almost called her Penny, to take Sugar, kind of like around.
And that's because she gives lots of sugar when she's
nervous. Well, why is she named Sugar?
Her name is Sugar because she likes to give lots of sugar when she's not nervous.
All right. So Let's try to find her a home. I'm going to have Arlene walk her around. Trust me, Soul Train Gang, you can walk home with a... You can walk on with a companion animal. And on a serious note, though, we have six shelters, and we do the best we can to try to find homes. But we have so many animals that sometimes that is not possible. So join me today. Join Animal Services today. And let's save this little doggie's life. Let's find her a home so we know we don't have to worry about her. This, if you want unconditional love, you will find it in Sugar. So I'm calling upon the people that can hear my voice, see me on television, that are here in these chambers. When we go home, when we end today, let's make sure someone takes Sugar home. Madam President, thank you very much for the time that you have afforded me today.
Very well. Let's find Sugar a home. Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. Marquise Dawson, peace, love, and soul.
Thank you so much, Madam Chair and members. I actually have two presentations this morning. Both are people that you all will know. First is one of our good friends and key members of the personnel here in Los Angeles City Council and City Hall, Gabriel Morales. He's been working at the cafe downstairs. And today is his last day. He is becoming a member of IBEW Local 11. So he will be an electrician with a very good job. And so we want to thank him for his service there and tell him how excited we are about what he's going to do in the future.
Just want to say thank you for the opportunity to be able to serve everybody here and lead by example in my community. And I'm fortunate enough to get an opportunity to move on in life. And hopefully I'll set the example for those behind me. Thank you.
Gabrielle's from Boyle Heights, so I'm filling in for Councilman Huizar today. All right, on to my second presentation. Today, as we continue to celebrate African American Heritage Month, we have a legendary and historic institution that blended music and television and showcased African American culture to the United States and to the world. The institution brought R&B, soul, hip-hop, funk, jazz, disco, and gospel artists to the American mainstream. That is, of course, the longest running program in syndication in the history of television, Soul Train.
Let's give them a round of applause.
Soul Train, as you can see on the video screen above, has been started back in 1965 with Don Cornelius as a radio show called Kitty A Go Go, and then Red Hot and Blues. Later on, it became a television program and moved and made a home in Los Angeles in 1971. Since 1971 all the way up until 2006, almost every important music star has appeared on the show. But what we wanted to do today, Don Cornelius, who we lost a few years ago, and the artists that performed on the show get lots of props all the time. We wanted to bring to the city of Los Angeles and recognizing and honor the dozens of people that danced on that show every week and pioneered what we all know as the world famous Soul Train line. So today behind me, we have from every decade, the 70s, 80s, 90s, and 2000s, members of the Soul Train dancers. Let's give them all a big round of applause.
Hey, Mr. Harris Dawson, I want to make sure we get a good shot here. So move over. Everybody get in the center aisle. Show off that good-looking hat and coat. No, Marquise, coordinated. We want to make sure everybody just get on either side of Marquise, but stay tight. And why don't we show the people that we have today? Yeah, why don't we switch from the video and let's go live from City Hall? Yeah. Now we're cooking with gas. Let's give them another round of applause. Everybody get in tight.
So many of these folks, I know I certainly recognize from waking up on Saturday morning, trying my best to learn the new dance moves and to learn what to wear to school the following week. But again, the Soul Train dancers, and we want you to hear this on behalf of the city of Los Angeles. You helped build the culture of this country. And you did it right here in our city, and we treasure you, we appreciate you, and we're proud to honor you today. I want to call up Reginald Rutherford, the senior operations manager from 1980 all the way to 2006, so 26 years, the person who helped organize all this. Come on up. Reggie asked me to make sure everybody understands that he's the organizer, he's not a dancer.
First of all, thank everyone, thank all the council, and this is the greatest fraternity in the world, folks, to ever know. We've had also some councilmen that have come from dancing from Soul Train. Don was more than just a visionary. He was a gentleman that had a large vision about where he was going. He didn't just do Soul Train. He has 26 award shows. He also has a comedy show and other television shows. So it was something there. But he loved his city. He loved Danny Bakewell. He loved a lot of the councilmen. And in between, some of you know, in your districts, there were a lot of things that he did in the community, which is real important. And I stand here for him and behalf of him, of what his vision was, not only as a friend, as a confidant, but as all these, well, they were kids then, but we have grandmothers and great-grandmothers and things. But I want you to know one thing that was perfect. They never, ever, ever did anything that was out of the ordinary. Don ran a pretty tight ship, and I guess I ran a pretty close ship. But I want you to know one thing in closing. All they did was dance for a bucket of chicken and a soda. Thank you guys again, and I love you.
Yeah, well, so many of us, we all grew up together. And there was a time when we didn't have DVDs and video, so you would know to make sure you were in front of a television so that you could see the latest in clothing, the latest dance moves, and it really kind of set a tone for the country. I was having a conversation with some individuals earlier. The dancing that you guys did is like the precursor to a lot of the exercise videos that you see today, where individuals have cardio workouts and things of that nature. So your effect will live on and on. And I had an opportunity of members to chat with them earlier today, and I was asked if I could bust a move. I indicated that I could not, but what I wanted to take a moment, though, and introduce to you, on this council, we do have a former professional dancer, and I wanted to introduce to you Council Member Mitch O'Farrell. Stand up.
Bravo, yes.
Who made a living at different portions throughout his life as a dancer. It's now, Mr. Harris Dawson, my pleasure to call on one of our colleagues, No singing. This is a dance. This is a dance show, Mr. Buscaino. It's not a singing show. Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, from the southern portion of Los Angeles, Joe Buscaino.
Thank you, Mr. President. And by no means am I a professional dancer, but I want to thank you for teaching me how to dance. Every Saturday morning, this son of Italian immigrants turned on Soul Train, and I was able to learn a few moves, and which led me to my love for the performing arts. So a heartfelt thank you for sharing your soul and your culture with the Buscaino family. And really please, Mr. Marquise Harris-Donson, thank you so much for bringing them here to Council Chambers to celebrate their love of family and their love for the city and their love for dance. So thank you.
And see, you guys have a lot of fans. So before we wrap this up, I have to now defer to the councilman from the 5th District, Mr. Paul Koretz. Paul, I definitely want to hear you about your dance. We want to hear about your dance experience.
Unlike Mr. Buscaino, I was beyond help. I have to admit, growing up, I did watch Soul Train. Didn't do me a bit of good. I have three left feet, but I still appreciate your talent, and it was entertainment for those of us who couldn't learn to dance, but it was great to see what people could do who could dance and dance very well. So on behalf of everybody that ever watched that show, I thank you.
And from the great 9th and now the new 9th Council District, I'd like to recognize Mr. Curran Price, Mr. Soul Train of the Council.
You know, you guys have just provided so much inspiration and excitement over the years. You know, we couldn't wait to turn on the TV and get the latest. Get the latest move. And I always appreciated the splits because I was concerned that somebody wouldn't be able to get back up. But you always did. You always did. Which one did the splits? Oh, there he is. All right. But don't do it now. But we just want to thank you for your contribution to our culture and to our community. And so we just appreciate you, and you represent the best in us, of us, and have been a real beacon of excitement and hope. So congratulations on your achievements. Congratulations on being real strong supporters of the community and giving back. I look around and see many of you at the events over the years. So keep up the good work. Thank you.
And you know, Mr. Price, you make me think of something else. We talk about the dance moves, and we talk about the great wardrobes and clothing. I think we need to also talk about the phenomenal hairstyles that, you know, throughout the, where, you know, we'd see you, and then that next week, everybody wanted to look like you. With that said, I'd like to call on the great rep from the 13th District, Mitchell O'Farrell.
Thank you. Thanks, Mr. President. I just have to say that before I became a professional dancer, I drew my inspiration from many sources, and one of them being Soul Train. I'm just so thrilled to be in the same room with all of you. For years and years, I woke up on a Saturday just to watch you all dance. And, you know, through being inspired by what I saw and kind of what translated through the screen, it really fed my desire to become a dancer. And way back in the day, I'm, you know, rural Oklahoma. Who from rural Oklahoma becomes a professional dancer, right? But that example helped someone like me, a kid in the 70s from rural Oklahoma, become a professional dancer. So no telling how many countless others with a background that maybe didn't necessarily lend itself to that possibility. Just know that you've influenced thousands, probably millions of people across the world who tuned in and saw what you did. So bravo, thank you, and it's just great to see you all here. Thank you.
Okay, Mr. Harris-Dawson, I'm going to defer back to you, but I'm going to see if I can't get Ms. Martinez to return to the president's chair, because I'm going to slip down there with you. Where are the city photographers? Sherry, get ready, because I may get inspired, all right?
Well, thank you so much, Mr. Chair and members. And again, one more big thank you to the Soul Train dancers and the inventors of the Soul Train line, the longest running television program in the history of television. I couldn't be more proud of them and more proud of this city. So again, thank you to the city. Thank you to the city council. And one more big round of applause to the Soul Train dancers.
Hey, Sherry, you ready?
Non-stop minutes across the tracks of your mind into the exciting world of Soul and the Soul Train Gang.
Mr. Harris Dawson, we're waiting for you to do the splits.
Afro Sheet.
Got a new Soul Train dancer that retired. I think it's kind of different.
Oh, right.
And I still teach dance in the National.
Okay, Madam Clerk, we're going to move on to item two.
And item two is called Special for Cards.
Okay, item two is called Special for Cards. The first speaker is Wayne Spindler. Mr. Spindler, item two.
And again, that's right. We need an easement on Dronefield Avenue and CD 7. I simply say change the name of the street to Don Cornelius Avenue. Thank you for doing that. I appreciate the change perfectly to give the easement for the new Don Cornelius Avenue in CD 7, formerly known as Bledsoe Street. What a tremendous honor this is. So I will support this item and the name change in the name of Soul Train. What a perfect opportunity. Item 2 was agendized for today. For once, the council did something right. For once, not just corruption today, but honoring the great Don Cornelius and Soul Train with item number 2. Thank you so much. Support the item. 1 minute.
That concludes cards on item 2. Madam Clerk, can you open the roll? Close the roll and tabulate the vote.
13 ayes.
Okay, item passes. Let's move on to item 7. Mr. Go ahead.
Item 7, called special for cards.
Mr. Spindler, item 7. Mr. Spindler passes on item 7, so that concludes cards on this item. Let's open the roll, close the roll, and tabulate the vote.
13 ayes.
Let's move on to item 8.
Also called special for cards.
Mr. Spindler, you fill out a card for 8 as well. He passes item for item 8. That concludes cards. Let's open the roll, close the roll, and tabulate the vote.
13 ayes.
Let's move on to item 7. I'm sorry, 10.
10, called special for cards.
Mr. Spindler, you filled out a card for 10 as well. Are you going to speak on 10, sir? He passes. That concludes cards for item number 10. Let's open the roll, close the roll, tabulate the vote.
13 ayes.
Let's move on to item 11.
11, called special for cards.
Mr. Spindler, item 11.
And again, yes, item 11. Absolutely, thank you. Worthwhile. To lease approval of office space at 10221, the African American Heritage Month building at Compton Avenue. This is a very good thing for the Watts Civic Center ACLP. Again, in the nature of racial peace and harmony, I support item 11. Normally, we would be against corruption, but when it comes to these important things in African History Month, we must come together, try to stop another riot, especially in Watts, for the Watts Neighborhood Council. And finally, the councilman from CD 15 has hung up his badge. And now Joe Buscaino is becoming a representative of the African community. He's giving up his LAPD pension. Thank
you, Joe. Mr. Spindler, you're not on the item. Thank you, sir. That concludes cards on item 11. Let's open the roll, close the roll, and tabulate the vote.
13 ayes.
Forthwith for Mr. Buscaino. Thank you, sir. The next item is go to item number 5.
Item 5, called special for cards.
Mr. Walsh, item 5.
John Walsh, blogging at HollywoodHighlands.org or at Jay Walsh Confidential or tweeting at Hollywood Dems. This is number 5. It's on the agenda all the time. Rent escrow account program. Many, many people have taken advantage of this. What this does on North Fulton, North Canoga, North Woodley, West Homeside, West 21st Street, if the landlord does not repair your unit where you live up to code, then you can have the city ban the landlord from collecting your rent. Instead, the money goes into escrow. The landlord has to pay directly to the city your rent. And believe me, when that happens, whatever has been happened gets quickly fixed up. That's it. There's somebody here.
Mr. Walsh, what do you need?
I'm going to hand this in.
Somebody. Sergeants, can you please take the note from Mr. Walsh? Thank you.
That's for the pets.
Next speaker is Wayne Spindler on item 5. Mr. Spindler passes. That concludes cards on this item. Let's open the roll, close the roll, and tabulate the vote.
13 ayes.
Let's move on to item 14.
Item 14, call special for cards.
Mr. Spindler, item 14. He passes. That concludes cards on that item. Let's open the roll, close the roll, and tabulate the vote.
13 ayes.
Let's move on to item 6.
6, call special for cards.
Mr. Walsh, item 6.
John Walsh, blogging at HollywoodHighlands.org, J. Walsh Confidential. This is an installation of the name of Ennio Morricone at, not Morricone, Morricone, at 7065 Hollywood Boulevard. I think it's actually an insult to Mr. Morricone to put a star up there, a brand new star, because it's going to fall apart. The state of the Hollywood Walk of Fame is terrible. The city council does nothing about it. The press does nothing about it. We put up the pictures. We'll put up a picture of Ennio Morricone, not Morricone, Morricone, so that everyone can see how terrible the stars look next to them. They're torn apart. They're falling apart. And people are having sex on the stars because we just added Hustler to Hollywood Boulevard.
Next speaker is Wayne Spindler on item 6.
Absolutely.
Mr. Spindler, you need to turn that off and
the
speak.
Greatest
the greatest
composer of music in the 20th century and 21st century. You don't even play his music. You don't even play one thing from this guy, Once Upon a Time in the West, Once Upon a Time in America. You don't even play his music. How the fuck can you have a presentation for this man and not even play his music? To let people know what this guy is. You've heard his music. A lot of people may not know his name because he spends most of his time on classical music and in Europe. He rarely ever comes to the United States. I've seen him perform in person. He performs operas and themes. He's won multiple awards. You don't even play. I tried to play his music just now. You can't even play. Why? Because he's white. Because whenever you have a presentation for somebody white, you can't play his music. That's why you don't play his music. And you want to put a star where? In a place where people have sex, where people have drugs, in a crime-ridden fucking neighborhood. That's the presentation for this man? Nobody's here on his behalf, are they? You people are unfucking believable. I try to play his music on a presentation, and I'm not on the topic? Well, fuck your star, and fuck you, because you have no respect for this great man.
Thank you very much, Mr. Spindler. That concludes cards on item 6. Let's open the roll, close the roll, and tabulate the vote.
13 ayes.
Mr. O'Farrell?
Madam Chair, just to clarify, this is not a presentation. This is simply a routine administrative process where the Bureau of Engineering, the Bureau of Engineers approves the installation of a star on the Walk of Fame. The celebration and presentation will actually be the ceremony of the Walk of Fame. That's how it has always worked out, so this is not a presentation. And for anyone who just heard that tirade, I apologize because we are held by First Amendment laws to let any crazy, wacko person come up here and say anything they want. And so we're just, we're held to that standard. So I apologize for everyone who was offended just then, but that's part of the deal in this council chambers. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. O'Farrell. Mr. Englander?
I'm glad you mentioned that under the First Amendment on in responding to that. I just wanted to add to that. I saw the look on the face of our interpreter, why he had to interpret that. And I'd like while I understand it's First Amendment, we've gotten some complaints from various interpreters here that the part of their job is to be exposed to that and have to say it. And while it's First Amendment, I'm really wondering also what the legalities we have to be under because their employees having to do that are. So if we could ask the city attorney to look into that and get back to us on that as well. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Englander. Let's move on to item 9.
Item 9, call special for cards.
Mr. Barajas, item 9.
Okay, so as I take this, you're trying to figure out how to reuse water. In this case, you're going to somehow direct funding for something called Portable Reuse Project. Unfortunately, obviously, we are in the 21st century, and we're thinking about reusing already used water. Anyways, I think people should get the fact, and I'll bring this up during general public comment, that the technologies does exist to create water, not reuse a water like what you already use, but what about also desalinization or other means of creating water, causing it to rain, ionization. But the funding obviously has to be promoted from where? From an intellectual source, which is called the human mind, or the ability to create these sources of water. I do believe that these green technologies, which is what the problem is, as opposed to real technological breakthroughs, I mean, it just shows you what kind of depravity we are in. Where your officials are promoting sources of technologies which are not sources of technological breakthroughs. These are backward technologies. And I know some of you do know that, but you don't know how to get the funding for it. Right? So what I'm saying here is don't invest in this kind of crap.
Thank you, Mr. Barajas. Next speaker, John Walsh. Item 9, sir.
Thanks. John Walsh, blogging at HollywoodHighlands.org, and Jay Walsh Confidential, tweeting at Hollywood Dems. Communication from the Board of Public Works relative to a grant of $120,000 for the WATE Reuse Research Foundation for the nitrosodimethylamine precursor strategy for direct potable reuse project. That's three lines. God only knows what that is. There's not a single person up here who knows what the hell that is. But you're all going to throw that $120,000 in because, you know, some of it will stick to the mayor and his gay lover, Glenn Dake.
Mr. Spindler, please stop clapping. Next speaker is Mr. Spindler on item 9. Are you speaking on this item or not? He passes. That concludes cards on item 9. Let's open the row. Close the row and tabulate the vote.
13 ayes.
Okay, item passes. Mr. Price, are you ready for your presentation, sir?
Madam President, members, I have a great honor this morning to acknowledge a group of extraordinary legal professionals in our community, attorneys who have been providing free legal workshops throughout the 9th District over this past several months. Collectively, they have successfully expunged records from over 200 residents, enabling them to apply for new jobs, credit, even home ownership. They successfully serviced over 150 people because of unlawful evictions and successfully saved people from illegally being thrown out on the streets. They have held elder abuse workshops, housing rights workshops, and will be holding immigration rights workshops, tax preparation workshops, homeowner rights workshops, all free to the community. Because of this and much more, it's my honor to present and acknowledge each of them with the following certificate. For your outstanding legal service and advocacy provided to the community of the 9th District, your exceptional leadership and dedication to developing a community legal service program for the underserved that has enhanced the quality of life of our residents and empowered them to create positive change for themselves, their families, and their neighborhoods. Your commitment to legal education and outreach has helped our community reach our goals for success for all residents in the 9th District, and we are appreciative and proud of your many accomplishments and efforts you have achieved through this community collaboration. Let's give it up for these outstanding legal professionals who are serving our community, not just the 9th District, but our community in general. Please, let's welcome them. Specifically, we want to acknowledge Fernando Gaitan, Alexander Herndon, Stephanie Lynn, DeSong Matthew, Kevin Reyes, Jennifer Wiseman, Leslie Ivy, Cecilia Francisco, and C.T. Turney. And we also want to acknowledge the following organizations: Legal Aid Foundation of Los Angeles, the Restoration Law Center, and A New Quality of Life. And so, again, we appreciate the role that these professionals are playing in improving the quality of life in our community and serving citizens who really deserve their assistance and help. And we thank you.
Mr. Price, we have Mr. Blumenfield that would also like to say a few words.
Just want to say, Mr. Price, thank you for bringing this forward. All great attorneys, I'm sure, but I want to pick out one in particular, someone I've known a long time, Leslie Ivy. Just want to congratulate you. I've known you since before you even had your law degree. We've been friends and my wife and myself, and we just are really proud of you, of the work that you're doing, that all of you are doing, but especially to you, Leslie. Thank you.
Congratulations to you all. Thank you, Mr. Price. Okay, Madam Clerk, let's move on to item 12.
Item 12 called special for cards.
Mr. Wayne Spindler, item 12, are you speaking on this item?
Thank you so much.
Mr. Spindler, can we start the clock on Mr. Spindler? You pulled a card for item 12.
We don't want to be interrupting the meeting with your presentations. No, we have to have... No, see, everybody's just all over the fucking place.
You need to speak on the item. I'm going to have you sit down.
The death of Justin Alexander Pitsnury, because I have to go into Nury mode, $50,000. Don't take the award, Nury. Nobody take the award for these item 12 and 13, these fines, these $50,000 lousy fucking dollars to go in the witness protection program. Don't do it. Say no to this. Vote no on 12 and 13. Marchese, vote no on 12 and 13. And the most important thing about this thing is fuck the police.
Next speaker, Mr. Walsh on item number 12.
John Walsh, blogging. You started, I have a bad knee. That's why it takes me to come up here. You hate cripples, don't you?
I do not, sir. I give you your time.
He started the clock.
I give you enough time to get up here,
sir. I know you don't give a shit. Number 12, an offer of reward for information leading to the responsible for the death of Justin Alexander Pitts. Nobody gives a damn about him. All you care about is your goddamn liquor licenses. And there was, and incidentally, if you're Korean, Rue gives you a 50% discount on the bribe.
Mr. Walsh, you got to speak to the item, sir.
Number 12. This is the conviction for the responsible death of Justin Pitts, who was killed by a drunk driver who drank the alcohol, which you gave the license to. There are too many fucking licenses in this city, you fucking scumbags. You're responsible for their death.
That concludes cards on item number 12. I want to apologize to the children that are in the back of the council chambers. Mr. Hunt, I need you to sit down, sir. I need you to sit down. I don't have a card for this item for you. That concludes cards on item number 12. Let's open the roll, close the roll, and tabulate the votes.
13 ayes.
Item passes. Let's move on to item 13.
Call special for cards.
Mr. Hunt, item 13, sir.
Subject for payment?
13. Item 13.
Yeah, $50,000 reward. I am for rewards. I am for catching the bad guy, and I'm not for killing, so go ahead and approve this one.
The next speaker is Wayne Spindler on item 13. He passes. That concludes cards on this item. Let's open the roll, close the roll, and tabulate the votes.
13 ayes.
Let's move on to item 3.
Call special for cards.
Mr. Walsh, item 3.
John Walsh at HollywoodHighlands.org. There is now no children in the audience, and there wasn't before. There were no children in the audience. You lied.
No, sir, there were children here.
As far as the alcohol consumption rate is concerned, this is another liquor license. Maybe you should apologize, Ms. Nuri Martinez, for this city having the highest rate of hit-and-run drivers in America and the highest rate of alcohol consumption outside of downtown Las Vegas. Maybe you should stop handing out liquor licenses, you son of a bitch. Maybe you should instead put a cap on them. But you don't give a fucking shit because it's not your kids.
Next speaker, Mr. Wayne Spindler, item 3.
Great fucking idea. Right after a hit and run, another fucking liquor license in this city. Necessity and convenience is the test. We have no necessity for another one of these fucking liquor licenses. But this guy Weezer, he's got to go and intoxicate the entire CD14. Every time somebody wants a liquor license in Jose Huizar's district, you're open to have it. Doesn't matter how many, doesn't matter who wants it, as long as you go to CD14 in Jose Huizar, you get your liquor license automatically. Automatically. Nobody gives a fuck here. Nobody reads this. Nobody here on this council, former cops, nobody gives a shit
about
it.
This
fucking liquor licenses are out of control in this fucking city.
The next speaker is Michael Carrion on item 3, sir.
I apologize to the children for the adult Thank you. As a recovering alcoholic myself, I ask you, how many liquor stores do you need? Every time somebody gets hurt or killed by a drunk driver, the council members here, some of you, care enough to show up for political reasons to say, oh, poor child, shouldn't have got killed, and blah, blah, blah. It's ridiculous, hypocrisy. This is what bothers me. Mr. Huizar has given more liquor licenses than hookers have given blowjobs. And it's getting to the point where lives are at stake here, and nobody cares. All you people sit here like a bunch of donkeys and just pass it on, pass it on. There's 13 people here, and there's 5 council members here. Oh, 6. Well, I don't know if he counts. But, and you guys just pass them and pass them and pass them. Liquor licenses. And then Mr. Huizar has the audacity to be on the board for the homeless. Alcoholism is a part of becoming homeless. Yet Mr. Huizar gives all the licenses, more licenses in the history of this city. Mr. Huizar has given more licenses, liquor licenses, in his district than anybody in the city of Los Angeles, any other council member. And I ask you, how could that be? Is it, in Spanish they call it la mordida. Is Mr. Huizar getting paid off?
Sir, you got to speak to the item, sir.
I am.
Item 3.
The item of a liquor license. Is Mr. Huizar getting paid for selling liquor licenses? That's a question. That is on this thing. Anyways, bottom line is, alcohol kills. And when it's your child, I hope you sit there and laugh.
Thank you, sir. The next speaker is Juan Alcala. Item number 3.
Yes, I will remind you of the history of alcohol. We gave alcohol to the American Indians.
This is not on
topic. And then we took their land. We give a liquor license. Shut up, city attorney. I'm talking. Don't interrupt. Do not interrupt. I'm talking about liquor.
Mr. Alcala, you need to speak to the item, sir.
I know. I'm talking about liquor licenses. They should not be allowed. You bunch of hypocrites. You, city attorney. Are you the real city attorney? Or are you just a substitute? Or a prostitute?
The speaker is off topic.
Mr. Alcala, this is your last warning.
My last warning. Thou shalt not call hypocrites, because they give liquor licenses to everybody that will put a dollar in the pocket of City Hall. City Hall is hungry for money. It's always hungry for money. Look at the parking meters.
You're not speaking on the subject, Mr. Alcala.
Yes.
Thank you very much. You're done, Mr. Alcala. Thank you. Thank you very much. That concludes cards on item 3. Let's open the roll, close the roll, and tabulate the vote.
13 ayes.
Item passes. Let's move on to item 1.
Madam President.
Mr. Englander.
Oh, can I, if I could, I'd actually like to reconsider an item from Wednesday's agenda, Council Item 160170-S8, and then have it continued for 30 days. So if we can move to reconsider that item from Wednesday first.
We are going to, okay, let's open the roll to vote on reconsideration on the item that Mr. Englander just mentioned. Let's open the roll, close the roll, and tabulate the vote.
13 ayes.
Wish for the item to be continued for 30 days, sir?
Yes, please. It was item 2E from Wednesday.
What day is that, Madam Clerk?
30 days would be March 18th.
Okay, the item will be continued until March 14th?
18th.
18th. I'm sorry about that. March 18th?
Thank you. And then also on 1H for today, if we can continue 1H for 30 days. Oh, well, go ahead.
So let's vote on the item that Mr. Englander just mentioned. Let's open the roll, close the roll, and tabulate the vote.
13 ayes.
Okay, and you wish to continue what other item?
1H for 30 days. That's on today, so we don't have to vote on that.
I understand that.
Okay,
thank
you very much.
Let's continue 1H for Mr. Englander for 30 days as well.
And Madam President, on item 1, there are requests to continue the items for 30 days to March 18th, and those items are 1B, 1C, 1D, 1E, 1F, 1I, and 1M for 30 days to March 18th.
Without objection, that will be the order. Mr. Buscaino.
Thank you, Madam President. If I may also reconsider from last Wednesday's council meeting, council file number 16010S35, that was item 1T. If we can vote on that reconsideration, please.
Okay, let's open the roll.
Thank you.
Close the roll and tabulate the vote.
13 ayes.
That item, if we can, Madam President, continue for 30 days.
Okay, the request is to continue the item for 30 days. Thank you. Let's continue on item 1.
Item 1, called special for cards.
Mr. Walsh and Mr. Spindler, you're both out of time. Next speaker is Michael Carrion. Item 1, sir.
Speaking on item 1A, which is in Mr. Huizar's district, and the reason why I'd like to speak on it is because I've lived there for so many years and I've tried and made so many frugal attempts to work with Mr. Huizar on a lot of these issues. And his staff is so incompetent that you can't speak to him. One of his staff members says that they're working construction on a retainer wall in Soto, which is was a cleanup job. So when these items come to the councilman's office to work with them, they get them all confused. A lot of these projects are fixed, are done, are cleaned, and they still have to pay fines because the councilman's office is incompetent, can't work with them. They can't do what they're supposed to do, so they end up screwing it all up for people that have to pay these fines. And these fines are ridiculous. In CD 14 on Valley Boulevard, we have sidewalks that are against handicap. You can't walk. You can't even take a walker through there. But you don't fix your property. Yet Mr. Huizar's out probably in some bar, you know, getting ready to drive another city car to get in another accident.
You need to speak to the item, sir.
Okay. But he's not here. And his staff's not here. And this is something that they're putting on here, and they're allowing to continue, and they're not saying nothing. These family members have already fixed this, yet it's here. They've called him, they went to his office, and they fixed the problem, but it's still here. I call that incompetence. That's why I called for a recall from Mr. Huizar. His staff can't work. His staff doesn't know what they're doing. They can't fix these problems, but yet you continue to push this problem. He's probably with one of his staff members now in a motel.
Thank you. Next speaker, Juan Alcala on item 1.
I just came from Barcelona.
Item 1.
Item 1, in L.A., people are stupid because they let city council put liens on them. On every property available, there will be a lien available for whatever reason. You see, all the city inspector has to go and see a bunch of leaves on the floor. Oh, this guy isn't cleaning his part of the sidewalk. Let's give him a lien and compound interest because the guy doesn't even know he's got a lien. You see, they don't serve him proper notice. They don't give him a what do you call those letters where you have to sign for it? You never send a letter where the owner of the house has to sign for it. Therefore, you are illegally putting liens on people, and you are the goddamn crooks that rule our world over here in L.A. There are other crooks in other cities, but they all do the same thing. You follow a pattern of government that has taken over the rights of the people. Who the fuck are you and Donald Trump?
Mr. Alcala, you're not speaking on item one, sir. No, you're not.
About liens, which are illegal. You levy illegal liens upon the people. And that is not, as the Jews would say, that's not kosher. You know? That's not
item
kosher.
Item one? Okay, thank you, sir. You're done. Thank you very much. That concludes cards on item one. Let's open the roll. Close the roll and tabulate the vote.
13 ayes.
Okay, item passes. Madam Clerk, let's move on to public comment. Mr. Walsh.
John Walsh, blogging at J. Walsh Confidential. I want to bring something out you haven't seen in the L.A. Times. Mr. Garcetti is 100% in favor of Hillary. I want all those people, all those limp-dick liberals who believe that Garcetti is Jesus Christ transformed. He is for Hillary. Now, he went out last weekend and campaigned for her in Nevada. He spit in the face of Bernie. He butt-fucked Bernie Sanders. That's what Hillary and Garcetti are doing. He is not a progressive. Garcetti is not a progressive, but he flirts with David Sionizer, the gay reporter, and the gay reporter at the Times falls in love with him and doesn't report the truth. He was out there. He's 100% eating out Hillary Clinton. That is his job, and he hates Jews like Bernie Sanders. That's your mayor.
Next speaker, Wayne Spindler, on public comment. Wayne Spindler.
So, I get thrown out of meetings, huh? Wednesday, the puppet Negro Herb Wesson threw me out for no reason at all. But today the hood returns. I left my hood back on Wednesday and I got thrown out. So when you come to these meetings, please wear a hood. You're guaranteed not to get thrown out. As long as you wear a hood or a swastika, you will not be thrown out of City Hall meetings. Failure to do so may result in rejection by the Uncle Tom, Herb Wesson Jr. At 1 o'clock today, they're going to have a secret meeting here at 1 o'clock to rewrite the DWP charter to make it 7 full-time paid members. Millions and millions of dollars of wasted fucking money, and no on Mitchell Englander for supervisor.
Next speaker, Michael Carrion. Followed by Jacqueline Richardson.
Yes, I've been here for several months, or 10 years, trying to discuss that retainer wall with Mr. Huizar's office. About a month and a half ago, his secretary, or his girlfriend, said that construction has started when it was just a cleanup. Mr. City Attorney, you might want to look into this. This was a lawsuit that was filed and won by the plaintiff. Now the city is paying for a contractor to do the work, but Mr. Huizar had city employees go clean it to make me believe that contractor had already started. So now you got a contract that's handed out by a lawsuit, and you got Mr. Huizar sending city employees to clean up that property before the contractor starts the contract. If that's not a misappropriation of employees, I don't know what is. Mr. Huizar sent city employees to clean up something that was already won by a lawsuit and should not have been done.
Next speaker, Jacqueline Richardson, followed by Brian Barajas. I love you people that are well informed.
Cuba, and Obama. What does this mean to Los Angeles? The Obama administration, according to a small TV station, Obama authorized Cuba in the near future to have 100 flights a day into the United States. It's supposedly for tourism, 100 flights a day. What does this mean to Los Angeles? Already 1 million people in Los Angeles, more or less, that need jobs. What does this so-called tourism mean to the city? Will there be enough jobs for everyone?
Thank you, ma'am. Next speaker, Byron Barajas, followed by Juan Alcala.
I turned in a leaflet to the, everybody on this side of the aisle. The fall of the Roman Empire, and you are there. Now, I think the process by which we're going to actually accelerate the powers to accelerate the mind of mankind is if we get the idea that World War III should not happen under this administration, Obama, or any other administration that's coming in, whether it be Hillary, Sanders, Trump, or anybody else. We have to really create the presidential candidate. Every citizen has to really develop in themselves what that aspect of being presidential or having a system of a presidency for the country, for the world means. We cannot tolerate Obama and his fascistic movement to annihilate Russia and China.
Mr. Alcala?
Well, I want to correct. He called Mr. Wesson and Uncle Tom. Mr. Price, Mr. Dasson, Mr. Wesson is not an Uncle Tom. He's just an Oreo cookie, black on the outside and white on the inside, which is a little bit different than Uncle Tom. I don't know what Uncle Tom means anyway, and I don't give a shit. But I want to question whether Hillary Clinton is an infomaniac or Bernie Sanders can still get it up or Donald Trump knows what the fuck he's talking about. I want to know, are you going to elect that redneck motherfucker? Are you? Are you going to elect that redneck motherfucker? I want to know. I want to know. I want to know. I want to know.
That concludes public comment. Mr. Hunt, I don't have a card for you, sir. Hold on for just a second. Don't yell. Do not yell. Hold on. I'm looking for your card. I don't have it in front of me. Hold on. Your card's not here, but go ahead. You have a minute.
Thank you. Here's what I gotta say to LAPD. Fuck Los Angeles PD. Or should I say, the crimes that they have committed, what they do is not permissible at the LA Police Commission. Our Pledge of Allegiance is called Fuck the Police by NWA, and the reason why they have capriciously abused their discretion, and I don't care what you say, I'm going to start at the top with the chief. The chief needs to be relieved. And the city of Los Angeles, you guys cannot stop the lawsuits that you guys lose. 99.9% of the lawsuits that are filed against the city of Los Angeles, you guys end up losing. Why? Because you guys don't have common sense. The people vote for you guys. Start listening to them.
That concludes public comment. Madam Clerk, what's before us?
Council has motions for posting and referral.
Posted and referred.
The desk is clear.
To members, are there any announcements? Mr. Harris-Dawson?
Thank you so much, Madam Chair. On tomorrow morning, beginning at 9 a.m. at Crenshaw Christian Center on 79th and Vermont, the firefighter recruitment section will be hosting a public safety career expo that will include LAFD, LAPD, and Los Angeles Airport Police Department as well. Everyone is welcome to get more information about how to begin a career in public safety on behalf of the City of Los Angeles. Thank you.
Thank you. Any other announcements, members? Mr. Buscaino, do you have an announcement?
Nope.
Anyone else? Just please rise for adjourning motions. Any adjourning motions? On my right, Mr. Koretz.
Thank you, Madam President. I just wanted to acknowledge the loss of another rock and roll player and an important individual, singer and band leader Dan Hicks, who died a little over a week ago at the age of 74 due to cancer. He had a unique blend of Benny Goodman and other swing era jazz greats styles, as well as folk bluegrass, the western swing in the style of Bob Wills, junk bands, gypsy jazz, the Andrew Sisters stylings in harmonics, the witty genius of Fats Waller's, and the blues. And they all went to the musics of Dan Hicks and his most notable group, the Hot Licks. As many of you will remember, Dan Hicks and the Hot Licks, his best known band. He first was the drummer for the Charlatans, one of the first bands of the San Francisco music scene that eventually led to the Jefferson Airplane, the Grateful Dead, and many others. He started the Hot Licks in 1968 with playful, carefree tunes and absurdly funny lyrics and use of swing music, scat singing, call and response, and strings. They offered a striking contrast to the typical psychedelic sounds of the era. And the New York Times said their music was defiantly unfashionable, proudly eccentric, and foot-tappingly catchy. He didn't go out of his way to become a commercial success, and they didn't have million-selling records, but they had a hugely, wonderfully wide and diverse loyal following that crowded any of their shows. And that was true during the original tenure of the Hot Licks, which lasted until 1973, when Dan Hicks disbanded the group at its height of popularity because he thought it was getting stale. Later on in the 1990s, when he put the group back together for live performances and new recordings, which went on for over 20 years. Stars who were big fans were honored to take part on those recordings, the likes of Bette Midler, Elvis Costello, Tom Waits, Willie Nelson, and Jimmy Buffett. The group continued to play to many intensely loyal fans and had many more dates lined up for the future. And while those concerts won't happen, the world of music will always appreciate how Dan Hicks carried the torch for our musical heritage in a fun but endearing manner. He's survived by his wife, Claire Wasserman, and his stepdaughter, Sarah.
Okay, any other adjourning motions? Mr. Harris-Dawson?
Thank you so much, members and Madam Chair. I'd like to ask that we adjourn in the memory of Denise Matthews, also known as Vanity, of the group Vanity Six, a 1980s women's group protégé by Prince. She was also the co-star of two 1980s cult classic movies, The Last Dragon and Action Jackson. We lost her at an early age of 57 due to kidney failure after years and years of struggles with alcohol and drugs. She later in life was able to get clean and get involved in the faith community and become a leader in it. Thank you all.
Thank you, Mr. Harris-Dawson. Any other adjourning motions? Seeing none, that concludes our meeting. Our meeting is adjourned. Have a wonderful weekend.